These white colored cells, along with the light pink colored and green colored cells, are called as shoot apical meristem of a plant. The light pink colored cells in the outer layer of meristem are secreting ligand CLB3 peptide. Adjacent to these light pink colored cells, some green colored target cells are present. These green colored target cells are expressing the CLB1 and CLB2 receptor proteins. The CLB3 peptide binds to the CLB1 or CLB2 receptor protein on the target cell. This binding stimulates the differentiation of the target cell. Now, let us take a closer look at the hypothetical signaling pathway through which CLB3 peptide stimulates the differentiation of a target cell. The plasma membrane of a target cell has transmembrane receptor proteins like CLAVATA1 and CLAVATA2. The abbreviation for CLAVATA1 is CLB1 and the abbreviation for CLAVATA2 is CLB2. When the ligand CLB3 peptide is secreted from adjacent cell, it generally binds to the CLB1 or CLB2 receptor on the target cell. This CLB3 binding causes autophosphorylation of CLB1. This autophosphorylation activates CLB1. The phosphorylated and activated CLB1 then phosphorylates the CLB2's cytoplasmic domain on its serine and threonines. As the receptor is phosphorylated on serines and threonines on them, they are called as receptor serine threonine kinases. These receptors are considered as the largest class of cell surface receptors in plants. Because the Arabidopsis genome codes for over 300 receptor serine threonine kinases, the extracellular ligand binding domain of CLB1 or CLB2 receptor has a tandem array leucine rich repeats. So, CLB1 or CLB2 receptor is also called as leucine rich repeats or LLR receptor kinases. The Arabidopsis genome codes for about 175 LLR receptors. The Rho family GTPase then binds to the phosphorylated CLB1 or CLB2 receptor and get activated. The activated Rho family GTPase then induce MAPK downstream signaling cascade that inhibit a gene regulatory protein in the nucleus called as Husqvarna. As a result, the Husqvarna become inactive. As a result, the target genes that inhibit differentiation are transcriptionally inactive so that differentiation proceeds. In some cases, when CLB3 peptide binds to the CLB1 or CLB2 receptor on the surface of target cell, the plasma membrane-bound serine threonine protein phosphatase inhibits its phosphorylation. As a result, the Rho family GTPase cannot bind to CLB1 or CLB2 receptor. As a result, the Rho family GTPase remains in an inactive state. This inactive Rho family GTPase
कैन नॉट इंड्यूस एमएपी के डाउन स्ट्रीम सिग्नलिंग कास्केड दैट इनहिबिट्स द जीन रेगुलेटरी प्रोटीन ह्यूस्चेल. एज ए रिजल्ट द ह्यूस्चेल बिकम्स एक्टिव. एज ए रिजल्ट द टारगेट जीन्स दैट इनहिबिट डिफरेंशिएशन आर ट्रांसक्रिप्शनली एक्टिव सो दैट द डिफरेंशिएशन स्टॉप्स. Please like, subscribe and share.